Best variety that we have currently is mostly the Honeycrisp. That's our biggest seller right now. It's a very sweet apple, but there are also other apples that are tart. We also have mixes of tart and sweet, such as the Empires. Now, there are several different varieties. On our orchard, we have over 29 different ones. Now, if you want to look for a good apple, you want a nice apple, you want to look at the color, you want to make sure it's got a nice, rich texture to it. The skin, you don't want it to be soft, at least not very soft. You want it to have a nice, good, firmness to it. Give it a little squeeze, make sure that it's not, your fingers don't push in or leave any fingerprints. You want to see a bad apple. This would be similar to a bad apple. You see that bruise on there? You don't want that on your apples. What you want is that. That's what you want your whole apple to look like. You want it to look nice and firm, and when you bite into it, you want it to crunch. You don't want it to become mealy, like you usually get in a grocery store apples. They're usually created to look nice, but the flavor is completely off. It'll just taste like you're biting into a water balloon. They're mealy, they're all gooey inside. Most places like Walmart will keep their apples for an entire year. They don't restock to new apples. When you come to our orchard, you get new apples pretty much every day. We don't keep them for extremely long. The ones that are bad, we usually turn them into pies, sauces, cider. So we use all of our apples pretty much everything we do.
So if I get an apple from your farm, how long can I expect it to stay good in my fridge?
You want it to stay good in your fridge, it'll probably last to about 1.5 to 2 weeks. You want to keep the apples as soon as you get them. You want to keep them away from other fruits, other things that'll spoil easily. Because as soon as you pick an apple, it'll start to immediately ripen. So it lets off a type of gas that will basically ripen anything else. So if you leave them near your bananas are going to go bad in a few days. But you want to keep an apple in a nice, cool place. You want them to be in the light, you want them to sit in the sun, or else they're going to go bad fairly quickly. You want to keep them in a nice, cool, dark place to make them last for a long time. You can even freeze them if you like, but I don't know how long they last in the freezer for.
So for cooking and for baking purposes, what are the best apple varieties to choose from?
The best apple varieties are pretty much any type of apples. We have several on here. We have a list of them all. Probably about pretty much 4 of our apple types that we got today are good for eating, baking, and sauces. The only ones that aren't are the Ozark Gold. Yellow apples usually aren't always the best for baking. They're usually good for eating and salads is what you want. Because yellow apples are nice and hard and sweet. When you bake with them, they'll become too crumbly or they'll really crunch. They don't get soft enough for a bake. But pretty much any other kind of red apples you get that kind of look like this or like these are good for baking. If you want a good baking apple, you want to look for something that's nice and round, good and solid. You got these ones of the Empire. Very large, good for cutting up. Probably put about 4 apples into a pie would probably fit. So we get apples of all different sizes.